Hello students, today I am here with one of the chapter from your supplementary reader book Moments. It is for grade 9. Let's begin with it. The Adventures of Toto by Ruskin Bond. Summary: the story narrates the adventures that followed after the narrator's grandfather, who was an animal lover, bought Toto a monkey. The story begins with grandfather buying Toto from a Tonga driver for 5 rupees. Toto was pretty and looked so out of place that grandfather decided to add him to his private zoo. He was, however, afraid of grandmother, who did not like him bringing home as many pets as he liked. So the narrator and grandfather brought Toto home and decided to keep him a secret from grandmother. Toto was extremely mischievous. The narrator at the point in the story writes that if there is a part of the brain specially devoted to mischief, that part was largely developed in Toto. Toto, on his first day, ripped open the peg to which he was tied, shredded the narrator's blazer, and tore up the wallpaper that grandfather had chosen for the walls. Toto was then transferred to the servants' quarter, where he lived with the other pets. Usually, most of grandfather's pets got along with each other. However, Toto kept all of them awake at night. To prevent further such issues, grandfather decided to take him, Toto, with him to Dehradun. However, the journey was not one grandfather was expecting. He and Toto made it through most of the trip without any incident, but at the railway turnstile, Toto suddenly poked his head out of the bag and scared the ticket collector. The ticket collector thought Toto was a dog and charged poor grandfather 3 rupees extra. Grandmother finally accepted Toto and gave him a comfortable home at the stable. His companion was their donkey Nana. However, when grandfather came to the stable to make sure that Toto was comfortable, he saw poor Nana struggling because Toto had jumped on her head and bitten her ears. Toto loved the warm bath that grandmother prepared for him. It was a treat for him. He would expertly check the temperature of the water and then enter the bath 1 foot at a time. Then he would soak and soap himself. Once he almost boiled himself because he did not realize that the kettle was still on the fire. He was saved by grandmother and pulled him out the kettle just in time. One day, grandmother had made pulao. When everyone entered the dining room, they saw Toto sitting on the table stuffing himself with rice. He threw a plate at grandmother, who had screamed at him. He also threw a glass of water at one of the narrator's aunts. Then Toto jumped out the window with the dish of pulao. He climbed all the way up the jackfruit tree and ate all the rice while everyone watched. Finally, to take revenge on the grandmother who had screamed at him, he threw the dish down the tree and laughed when it broke into pieces. This incident made everyone, especially grandfather, realize that they could not keep Toto for long. He was becoming very expensive for them to keep because he kept destroying things. They could not keep replacing them all the time. So grandfather took Toto back to the Tonga driver, but he could only sell him back for 3 rupees. Thank you very much for watching this video. Make fair notes of this chapter as the PDF of question answers and textbook exercise and LR solution has been shared with you. See you till next video. Stay home, stay safe.